This is the third quarter update for the Amplify ETF's digital and online trading ETF, symbol BIDS. Today, I'm speaking with Christian Magoon, CEO of Amplify ETFs. Christian, since this is a new ETF, let's start with the investment thesis.
Yeah, Jay, it's really interesting when you look at life across the board, whether it's retail, whether it's some of the different types of technologies that are happening now, we're seeing a digitization of everything. And that includes trading, trading securities, stocks, bonds, commodities, digital assets, NFTs. And that's really why we launched the BIDS product. This is the first ETF to access a group of companies that are behind online and digital trading of all types of assets. So this includes e-brokers, digital asset trading platforms, market makers, the whole gamut. One way for you to get exposure to this area that really isn't found in the traditional financial ETFs and represents what we think a great growth opportunity going forward.
So Christian, as a new fund, could you walk us through how the portfolio is positioned?
Yeah, so this portfolio has about 60% of its assets in e-brokers. Now, who are those? Charles Schwab is probably the most well-known, but we have new players, SoFi, for example, Robinhood. These are companies that really focus on digital or online first initiatives. Many investors are interacting with them via an app on their phone or on their computer. About 20% of the portfolio, or a little less than 20% of the portfolio, is in digital asset marketplaces. So probably the most well-known is Coinbase. But we also have companies like Silvergate in this area, very kind of additive to the traditional financial type ETF. There's also trading platforms and market makers represented in here. So a company like Virtu or MarketAxess would be great examples there. So this is a very unique group of securities. If you own a traditional financial ETF, you don't own many of these companies. And these are some of the fastest growing companies out there in terms of trading volume, in terms of new customers, and really are positioning themselves for the next round of kind of this wealth transfer. They essentially dominate the millennial and Gen Z market and do pretty well in the baby boomer and Gen X market as well. So this is a future forward type ETF that allows you to have exposure to this whole financial ecosystem, but a group of companies that are really underrepresented by traditional broad-based financial indexes and ETFs.
So Christian, what are the rules for portfolio construction for this product?
Yeah, so this is an index-based product. It's a modified market cap weighting scheme. So essentially that means that it's market cap weighted with a cap on how large a company can be. That's 8%, that cap at rebalance. So you see a variety of companies in this portfolio. They all have to meet a revenue test. Essentially 50% or more of their revenue have to come from these activities for digital and online trading. So there is a certain pure play nature to this because of that revenue test. And again, when you see these companies, whether it's digital asset marketplaces or e-brokers, they're quite additive to most financial exposures that are out there in today's marketplace. It's a little bit of a scratch your head moment because you wonder why these companies really aren't part of those legacy type ETFs and indexes. But we think this is, again, a disruptive event, and you need to have kind of a new set of rules, a new type of index that captures these companies and bundles them together for investors to access.
And so, Christian, in your opinion, where does this fit into a diversified portfolio?
Yeah, so the easy answer would be it's very complementary to existing financial exposure. So if you have a financials allocation, whether it be to an index fund or maybe an active fund in the financial space, you'll find that BIDS adds a fair amount of diversification because it really emphasizes these e-brokers and digital asset marketplaces. Some of these aren't even included in those traditional areas. Now, another area to think about in terms of allocating is just a general growth or innovation sleeve. These companies are growing quickly. They're very innovative in terms of technology. They're on the front part of the way for the digitalization of financial kind of technology or decentralized finance, DeFi. So if you're looking to kind of play that angle via financials instead of maybe doing this traditional tech disruptive kind of approach, this would be another area to consider BIDS for that growth or innovation allocation.
To learn more about the BIDS ETF, please visit BIDSETF.com. That's BIDSETF.com. Thank you, Christian.
Thanks, Jake.